Hello, my name is Yasar Dogan. I'm a solicitor advocate at Redstone Solicitors, specialising in UK immigration and nationality law. In this video, I'll be talking about the new UK eVisa system. What is the eVisa system? The eVisa system is about the digitalisation of the UK immigration system, and it involves replacing physical immigration documents with a digital record of a migrant's immigration status. The new online record is known as an eVisa. This means that by the end of 2024, physical immigration documents such as BRPs, that is biometric residence permits, BRCs, that is biometric residence cards, wet ink visa endorsements in passports, and physical vignette visa stickers will be phased out. Instead, the visa or immigration status of all migrants will be recorded electronically, and it will be accessible online via a UKVI, that is UK Visa and Immigration account. Migrants will then be able to use this online information for the purposes of travelling to the UK and proving the right to live, the right to work, and the right to rent in the UK. Which visa immigration status documents are being replaced by an e-visa? The physical documents being replaced with an e-visa include biometric residence permits, biometric residence cards, wet ink visa endorsements in passports, and physical entry clearance or visa vignettes. The Home Office guidance states that if you have a physical immigration status document, you must continue carrying it until the end of 2024 when travelling abroad. Who is affected by the change? All migrants who live in the UK with limited or indefinite leave to remain are required to create a UKVI account in order to be able to access their e-visa. You are not affected by this change if you are a British citizen or Irish citizen holding a British or Irish passport, or you have the right of abode. Also, if you have a biometric residence card and you have been granted settled or pre-settled status under the EU settlement scheme, you already have an e-visa and a UKVI account to access it. You don't need to take any action. Likewise, if you have created a UKVI account when applying for your current visa, you may not need to repeat the process. Is it compulsory to register for an e-visa? Yes, the process is compulsory. All affected migrants are expected to register by the end of 2024 by creating a UKVI account. When should I create my UKVI account? You'll need to create your UKVI account by the end of 2024. You or your legal representative will receive an email from the Home Office inviting you to create your account. It's unclear whether any problems would be caused if you create your account before receiving an invitation email. However, to avoid potential complications, it's advisable that you don't. Will this change affect my immigration status? No, the change won't affect your immigration status. The period or conditions of your permission to stay will remain the same. If you have limited permission to stay, you'll need to make your extension application before your current permission expires. How do I get an e-visa and a UKVI account? This depends on what physical immigration status document you have. If you have a BRP that expires on the 31st of December 2024, the Home Office will send you an invitation email to create a UKVI account and access your e-visa by the end of 2024. If you don't have a BRP or BRC and you have another type of physical document, such as an indefinite leave to remain or indefinite leave to enter endorsement in your passport in the form of a wet ink stamp or a vignette sticker, then you are required to obtain a BRP first and then get an e-visa and UKVI account. If you are in this situation, we strongly recommend that you take action immediately. How do I create a UKVI account to access my e-visa? Once you've received the relevant invitation email from the Home Office, you'll need to follow the instructions in the email to create your account. In order to complete the process, you'll need an email address and a telephone number, access to a smartphone, and your BRP. You will then be required to complete a three-stage process. First, you'll be asked to create a UKVI account. This involves completing an online form on your computer or smartphone. Secondly, you'll need to download the UK Immigration ID Check app on your smartphone and confirm your identity using this app. In the third stage, you'll need to sign in and complete a few final details, including account security questions. Once you've completed these three stages, you'll have linked your eVisa to your UKVI account and you'll receive an email from the Home Office confirming that you can now access your eVisa in your UKVI account. What will I use my eVisa and UKVI account for? You have now created your UKVI account and linked it to your eVisa. This means that you are now able to access the View and Prove service. You can view and share information with third parties regarding your immigration status and any conditions attached. For example, when you need to prove your right to work to your employer or your right to rent to your landlord, you'll be able to access your eVisa via your UKVI account and share the relevant information with them. When traveling to the UK from abroad after the end of 2024, you won't need to carry your BRP with you. The immigration officers will be able to check your status digitally on your arrival. What if I renew my passport or my immigration status changes? When your immigration status changes, for example, by way of a successful application for an extension of your permission to stay, this will be reflected on your e-visa automatically. However, if your personal details change, it is your responsibility to update your details by accessing your UKVI account. You'll need to update your details if there are changes to your identity document, passport, or travel document, your email address or telephone number, your name or nationality, and your home or postal address. It's very important that you keep your details on your UKVI account up to date. What is the cost of having an e-visa and a UKVI account? The Home Office doesn't charge any fees for this process. If you can complete the process yourself, there will be no costs. However, if you need to use the services of a solicitor or other legal representative, you may have to pay a fee. How can Redstone Solicitors help me with my e-visa and UKVI account? As a firm of solicitors specialising in UK immigration and nationality law, we can help you create a UKVI account and link it to your e-visa. We can also provide guidance on how to navigate around and use your account. We hope that this video has given you an overview of the new e-visa system. There will be further videos on this topic. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave comments below. Goodbye for now.